¿Qué tal, amigos? Estamos de regreso. En un momentito les vamos a platicar qué es lo que está pasando aquí en Universal Studios. Estamos aquí con el doctor John Hammond.
Me llamo doctor Juan Hammond.
Eso, Juan Jamón.
Juan Jamón.
Ok, and...
But you can call me John.
John. Hello, John.
Hello, John.
Estamos transmitiendo en vivo con el creador de este parque.
Exactamente.
Me acompaña mi amiga Astrid Vega.
Hola, chicos, ¿cómo están?
Hola.
Y bueno, les queremos mandar un saludo. John les quiere mandar un saludo a todo México. Uh-huh. Que vean cómo se está celebrando este 25 aniversario.
25 años.
25 años. Uh-huh. Y además, pues qué gusto poder ver este tipo de personajes, ¿no?
De luminarias.
Queremos mostrarles completamente
el atuendo del señor John Hammond, incluyendo lo que es el cane, que fue proporcionado por Universal. Creemos que es un prop, no es el prop original, porque sabemos que lo tiene Steven Spielberg, pero este es lo más cercano que vamos a poder encontrar al prop original de la película.
Y lo mejor de todo, tiene ADN adentro de dinosaurio, por supuesto.
Ajá, exactamente.
Y bueno, pues vamos a seguir transmitiendo en vivo este tercer día, que es ya el día del cierre del evento.
Uh-huh.
Espero que les guste mucho todas las transmisiones que vamos a tener aquí.
Uh-huh.
John, ¿algo que le quieras decir a los fans de México?
Something you would like to say to the fans in Mexico.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
¿Qué más podemos pedir, chicos?
Los amigos están en México,
uh-huh,
cerca de Costa Rica.
Sí.
Yeah.
Sí. La primera parque de Jurassic en vivo en Costa Rica.
¿Ya? Yeah.
¿Cómo se dice?
Abrió.
Abrió en Costa Rica, pero mi corazón abrió en México.
Muy bien.
Thank you, babe.
Muy bien.
Muchas gracias, John, por esta entrevista.
Vaya con Dios.
Fue un placer.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Bueno, chicos, seguiremos transmitiendo el día de hoy a lo largo del día, así que chéquenlo.
Amigos, ¿qué tal? Va el segundo spot del día de sí, muchos que habrá.
Vamos a ver a qué otras luminarias nos encontramos.
Puro actor.
Miren quién está allá atrás de mí. Vamos a platicar. ¿Será? Oh my God. Excuse me. Wow. Are you Dr. Henry Wu and Dr. Ian Malcolm?
Yeah, yes. Yeah. Hello.
Oh my God. This is such a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh my God.
To meet you.
Where are you guys visiting from?
From Mexico.
Oh, Mexico. All right.
Yeah.
South. We're nice and warm.
Yeah, very, very close to Costa Rica, though.
Yeah. We had all those issues that you...
back in 1993,
yeah,
right?
Way back.
Yeah,
then.
I mean...
Oh, it's an honor to have you here and giving this little chat with us. We come from Mexico City and we are we want to
know how have you been experiencing this celebration, though this three past days, the celebration for Jurassic Park.
It's amazing. I mean, the fact that originally I didn't think any of this would work out. I mean, they did all this work. They created all these things. I mean, because they could do it. They never thought that they should do it. It turns out.
Oh, I know.
After all the publicity and everything, they should have done it. It turned out well.
Yeah, definitely. It's definitely really nice to see everybody coming from all over the place to be able to see the work that we do.
I think everybody has the right to see these animals, right?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Just, you know, the precautions should be in place.
I heard
it's definitely already there. It's just making sure that's what
you said last time. Then there was the running and the biting.
I heard that you were the one who created all these dinosaurs
in this park.
In this park.
Yeah, I was the one who definitely created the model to actually get the genetic code ready.
Built on the work other people had done, not something
well,
earned yourself.
Well, other people
yourself.
Really wanted to wait till they got the 100% of all the DNA. I found a way to make it a little cheaper and actually expedite the process by using different kinds of DNA to fuse with the ones that we found. To be able to actually create them earlier.
And then life found a way, and...
And here we are.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and look, 25 years later, and we have this privilege to find out.
But to be talking with you guys.
You had your job, you had your creations, and you had the reason all this time long.
Yeah.
You were right.
I was. It wasn't anything I took too much pride in because of the tragedy. But nonetheless, you can see how much people have come to enjoy what John put together in the first place.
Well, guys, this was an amazing finding. We are not keeping you anymore. I know you guys are busy with everything, all the preparations and everything that's going on. I hope that a helicopter is not from a dinosaur loose or anything.
No, that couldn't happen again.
It doesn't happen very often. So you guys will find... Yeah. Everything's contained. Yeah, we've designed it so that if things do get out of control, they don't survive without us. So
I'm going to make sure I get to the boat early this time.
Okay.
There's no need to do that. There's no need.
Thank you, Ian.
All right, well, thank you guys.
Just, I wanted to ask you a favor. Could you please say something to Mexico fans?
Oh, what would you guys like
about,
to say?
What's your... to send some greetings to Mexico fans, actually.
Oh, well, To all our fans out in Mexico, thank you guys so much for following us and the work that we do. We hope you enjoy all the videos that I'm sure you guys are going to be taking and showing you guys.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, this was Dr. Henry Wu, Dr. Ian Malcolm, who has already...
Who has left the building.
And thanks a lot.
Okay, guys. Thank you so much, Dr. Wu, and we're going to keep continuing with this transmission of this Jurassic Park 25th anniversary celebration. And hopefully we're finding more people, more guys to talk to, and we're going to be showing you more stuff that we couldn't show you yesterday. So stay tuned.
This is really exciting, and stay tuned. Bye.
Okay. Bye, guys. Hey, guys, we are continuing with our live streams through the Jurassic Park 25th anniversary celebration. And, oh my God,
who's
this?
Here.
Hello.
Oh my God, are you Dennis Nedry? Oh my God.
I'm recognizable.
This is so nice to meet you, Dennis.
Hello there, hello. Hi, Dennis.
Hello.
It's a pleasure to have you here. We come from Mexico and we want to ask you, what has been your experience through all these three exciting days here at Universal Studios Hollywood?
Well, InGen's a very important company.
I bet.
What I do is very technical, and not everybody could do it. You're welcome. vending machines are always stocked, and we produce... things that nature couldn't.
What are you eating? Oh, you're eating
something out of the vending machine. Low blood sugar. Blood sugar indeed.
Oh, of course.
Mm-hmm. I had my doubt. So you did really went to the vending machine, right?
Well, I go to the vending machine every day.
Oh. Yeah, of course.
That's why.
Mm-hmm. So talk more about your work in Jurassic Park. What exactly is that that you do?
Well, I'm in cryogenics. And the important thing to do also at Jurassic Park is always make sure you're on time for the last ferry. So.
Oh,
but it's
I
very
bet.
Top secret work, you know.
Oh, I bet. But without you guys, we couldn't have the dinosaurs we have today.
Nope, not at all. It's all because of me.
Oh, Dennis, I want to ask you, what could you give send a message to Mexico fans?
Okay. Make sure you're always on time for the last ferry.
Okay. Now, there was Dennis.
And we hope to see you soon.
Awesome. Thank you so much,
you're
Dennis.
Very
We're
welcome.
Not taking more of your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dennis.
Well, catch that ferry.
So, guys, that was Dennis Nedry right here in Universal Studios Hollywood. Well, we're going to be showing you more stuff. I hope we're finding more people to interview here. We're showing you some of the games that we couldn't show you yesterday. How about if we do that right now?
That would be excellent because yesterday we ran out of time and we had to to live. If you saw our last video, we had the Jurassic pinball game shut down just in front of our eyes, and wow. The Jurassic World Evolution and the Blue virtual reality experience. And we may be going right there. What do you think?
Yeah, let's go. Let's give it a try, shall we? Okay.
We're also showing the back of
check
of
that
our
out.
Stream. This gyrosphere, the Pteranodon, and the Wrangler.
The original Jeep Wrangler from Jurassic Park. It was brought from the back lot here so fans could see it, and of course not touch it, but so we could all see it.
We're having the greatest time of our lives.
We are, actually. So let's go watch some games. How about that?
So yesterday we reviewed the Jurassic World Alive, which was a kind of a GPS game that...
Like Pokemon Live, but don't say anything.
Yes, we must not make any comparison between them. Okay, so we were yesterday reviewing the Jurassic pinball. Park pinball game, which we are going to...
To try again today.
Try again, hi.
Okay. Robert is trying it.
This is Robert from Mexico City. This is Astrid Vega from
Hi.
Guadalajara.
Nice to meet you.
We want to, if you could tell us something about the Jurassic World pinball game.
Yeah, of course. So we're Zen Pinball. The pinball app is actually free on all mobile devices. And then we have three different Jurassic-themed tables with this pinball pack, which is really exciting. The first one is Jurassic World. The second one is Jurassic Park, which is classic. And the third one is Jurassic Mayhem, which is really fun. Everyone has to check that one out. I mean, right now we're featuring it as mobile, but it's also available on Pinball FX3, which is on console. Oh. Yeah, so if you have an Xbox One, PlayStation 4, Nintendo Switch, or if you have Steam and PC, it's available on all of those as well.
Yeah, we've already reviewed that one on the PC. I got that game a little earlier from our friends. They were so kind to show it to me a little earlier, and I tried it, and it's so much fun.
It is. It's tons of fun.
So, okay.
Let's show them how the game works.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Yeah, please. If you could show us how this works.
So first, just like the physical pinball table, you pull the ball back like this, pull the pin back to release the ball, and then you tap underneath the flippers here just to activate the flippers, and it's just like a old school pinball, but with on a screen. It's all digital.
Is there by any chance a comparison between the real machine back in 1993 and this game, or is this a completely new, different display of the board game?
He means that if the game looks a little bit like the old pinball game, like the actual thing from 1993.
No, so this one is an original design from Zen Studios, which is really cool. We actually got to use some sound bites that were original from the actual movie, so that part was really cool. So that's probably the feature that we love most about it is the original sound bites from it.
That's awesome. And also I saw on the trailer that there are a few scenes when you get as many points or something like that, and that you get a little scene from the movie or something like that.
Yep, so on different pinball tables, there's different game modes, so they're pretty exciting. I think Jurassic World is probably my favorite with the game modes because the little velociraptors come out and can eat your ball and stuff, and so there are different game modes, and they show different parts of the movie. They feature some of the things in there, so that's really exciting.
Awesome.
So the difficulty, it keeps improving as long as you keep playing, right?
The difficulty keeps improving.
Yeah, it gets a little harder.
Yeah, so it doesn't necessarily get harder the more that you play, but you are competing against people all over the world, that's kind of where it comes in. So your leaderboards, you're competing against people everywhere. So leaderboards are pretty competitive, which is what's really fun about this. Also on console with Pinball FX3, it's the same thing. You're competing with people all over the world. So that's what's the difficulty. That would be the only thing that would increase, is that you're competing against other people. Here, it's just kind of your skill. You're really trying to get certain game modes to activate so you can earn more points in the game modes.
Okay.
So it's just like a regular pinball. It's just about making points.
Yes.
Well, that's fantastic because there, then you don't need that much specific skill to be playing it. You're just having fun with it.
Exactly.
As long as you're not too competitive, right?
Yes. Right. Yeah, so on our mobile device as well as on our console devices, both game formats have like a table map that kind of directs you on where you want to get your ball into to get the most points and earn the most points possible. So that's always exciting. On Pinball FX3, on console, it's also exciting because we have little tutorials on how to play pinball. So if you've never played before, it'll shoot you little tests so that you can improve your skill so that, you know, it's not as hard to compete against all of these people from all over the world. Okay. So that part's really fun.
Plus, the board looks so much fun.
Yes.
And it has great graphics.
Yes, it does. It has great graphics. So what you guys are just seeing right now is the Jurassic World table, which is obviously themed off of the movie Jurassic World. And we have two others. It's very fun. My personal favorite is the original Jurassic Park one.
Yeah, it looks more classic, right?
Yes, yes, it's fun.
What I really like about the Jurassic World scene is that the Mosasaurus, it eats your ball sometimes.
Yeah, it does. So there's, it's pretty exciting. The ball can get stuck on the little, I don't even know what you would call it, the little machine that would take out the shark, you know, and would feed
the crane, right?
The claw.
Yeah, the claw. I guess you could call it that. It's pretty fun. So
little Toy Story reference back there.
Yeah.
a few weeks ago, we were reviewing the these arcade games and machines that are found at Las Vegas or Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
And this is great because we need more different games, and this is perfectly what we were needing and expecting as a fan.
Yeah. Exactly.
Awesome.
Of course, if you were to make this in an actual arcade or something, not just mobile, like the actual box, so you can purchase it, it would be amazing, like the actual pinball, you know?
Yes, that would be fun. You should, everyone, fans, keep your eyes out, because Zen Pinball is actually in the process of soon to be releasing physical pinball cabinets with all the mechanical buttons and pull levers, but it's going to have a digital screen, so the digital is actually going to respond to what you do physically with buttons and levers, and that will soon be releasing for home use, so you guys will be able to buy it for your homes. I think that's all I'm allowed to tell you now, but keep your eyes open.
Okay, we
am I an oracle or what?
Now I have a doubt. I guess this is not going to be promoted in Mexico. Do you have any info if it is going to arrive to our country?
So I actually don't have any details at this time on that. Not everything I'm allowed to say yet. Okay. So just keep your eyes open, and if it does go there,
we hope and please consider us. We would like to.
Well, even if it doesn't arrive at Mexico, trust me, we are going to get it.
We are going to get it. It was nice to meet you and talk with you.
Okay, well.
Guys, so thank you so much. This was so much fun.
Awesome.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, guys, you saw the Jurassic World Pinball. It's called Jurassic World Pinball, even though just one of the games is Jurassic World. The other two are Jurassic Park and Jurassic Park Mayhem, which is a combination of all the other games.
There's no Lost World.
No,
I
it's...
You mentioned that.
It's more like Lost World meets Jurassic Park 3, something like that.
Something like that.
Yeah, okay.
Well, we're going forward to... The event is about to start.
Okay, yeah. We're moving forward to the Jurassic World Evolution booth.
Here is Dr. Ian Malcolm again.
And I'm working on the new Jurassic World Evolution. It's a game made by that team at Frontier. So I'm going to be with you the whole game as Dr. Ian Malcolm. That's the character that I play in those Jurassic Park movies. I highly recommend it. It gets 10 Goldblums out of a possible 10 Goldblums. That's my highest rating.
So now we saw that it gets 10 of 10 Goldblums.
Now we're going to see some footage of Jurassic World Evolution right here on the screens. As you can see, there are some people actually trying it. We're going to finish the transmission right here. because there's too much people here and we don't want to be in the way. We'll be coming back a little bit later to show you more awesome things here at the Jurassic Partners section. Check that out. We still have tons of things to show you. So, stay tuned for more Jurassic Park news in just a moment. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. No se puede. Emocionante de la noche.
We are so happy. Please let me say one thing. Welcome to Jurassic Park!
Thank you, Dr. Hammond. That was very reassuring. We have our partner. partners here tonight. They're here showcasing all kinds of really great toys and games inspired by the franchise. If you go down the line of Jurassic Park, you will see Oculus is here with their VR experience. Mattel is here with some toys. We've got some mobile games by Ludia, pinball games by Zen Studios, all kinds of really great stuff down there. So please go and see that. We also have some great photo opportunities for you. The Jeep is down there, the gyrosphere from Jurassic World. We also have our live specimen. They will be out momentarily. We have. I would like to introduce Dr. Wu.
Good evening, guys. Thank you guys so much. My name is Dr. Henry Wu. I am the chief geneticist here at InGen. First off, thank you guys so much for coming tonight. It means so much to see all of you guys here, and I'm so thrilled to be able to show you guys what we are doing here, what we have prepared to show you guys. Back next to the Jurassic Partners, we have an amazing gallery display full of fossils and a lot of artifacts, so make sure you come check us out.
Thank you, Dr. Wu. Thank you so much. Next up, I would like to introduce Dr. Ian Malcolm.
Thank you. I think definitely the model for tonight's festivities should be life away. Thank you,
Dr. Ian Malcolm. Next up, I would like to introduce Mr. Dennis Edry.
Nobody cares.
Thank you, Mr. Nedden. And last but not least, our founder, Dr. John Hammond!
As you can see, with all we have going on here tonight, we've spared no expense! Yeah. Carry on, Mr. MC.
Thank you, Mr. Hammond. Now, if you would like to own your very own copy of the original Jurassic Park, we have it in our retail space. But also, we have the 25th anniversary edition Blu-ray 4K. That will be out on May 22nd, so keep a lookout for that. Now, I don't want to wait any longer.
We could take a little moment to make an interview with you. We'll come from Universal Mexico.
Whatever you say.
It's just a little interview from Universal Mexico. We are big fans.
Amigos, ¿qué tal?
Hola, chavos, ¿cómo están?
Estamos transmitiendo en vivo desde el Jurassic Park The Ride.
Estamos a punto de subirnos por última vez, pero primero queremos platicarles cómo estuvo el panel del día de hoy, el último día. Estuvieron de nuevo auspiciando Colin Trevorrow. Los invitados especiales fueron Jeff Goldblum, John Rosengrant, no recuerdo cómo se llama, el director de Kong Skull Island, el director de Rogue One, y el director y el asistente de dirección que también estuvo aquí el viernes.
Y bueno, lo interesante aquí es que la gran sorpresa de Jeff Goldblum, ayer alguien nos pasó el tip, no podemos decir quién, no podemos decir cómo, pero nos enteramos y decidimos precisamente por eso volvernos a presentar aquí a terminar nuestro review de la celebración. Y bueno, pues esos rumores fueron ciertos. Jeff Goldblum estuvo presente, estuvo a unos metros de nosotros e incluso les tenemos la noticia de que incluso hasta nos dio la mano a ambos antes de empezar el panel de discusión.
No solo nos dio la mano, sino que aparte de todo pudimos pasar al backstage y estuve a una nada de que Jeff Goldblum me diera una entrevista, si no fuera porque no estaba permitido. De hecho, él ya me había dicho que sí, me había dicho sí, te doy una entrevista, y en eso llegaron todos los guaruras y, no, ¿qué están haciendo aquí? ¡No, váyanse!
Y bueno, quiero platicarles el cómo están sucediendo las cosas. Tuvimos la fortuna de tener contacto con una persona lindísima que se llama Athenia, que nos hizo la vida el día de hoy. Sí. Les voy a mostrar tantito. Nosotros venimos realmente por nuestros propios medios para poder estar aquí. Eso es un pase de visita. Sin embargo, el día de ayer conocimos a Athenia y hoy la volvimos a encontrar y nos platicó cómo nos fue en nuestros videos. Esperamos que hayan sido muy exitosos y que les haya gustado mucho. Y fue entonces cuando me dijo, oye, pues, ¿te puedes revisar? ¿Cómo puedo revisar los videos? Y le dije, pues si quieres te los anoto. No te preocupes, mira, toma mi tarjeta y ¿me puedo registrar aquí? Sí, toma. Y me dio un pase, lo voy a mostrar, que dice Media. ¿Qué significa que es Media? Que
es prensa.
Pues, prensa digital, básicamente. Uh-huh. Eso me dio acceso nos está dando en este momento acceso a todos los espacios donde no habíamos tenido antes oportunidad de transmitirles en vivo. Al grado que pues hubo un momentito pequeño, se alcanza a ver exactamente cómo Astrid alcanza a saludar a Jeff Goldblum. Le empieza a solicitar que le regale unos minutos, pero pues desgraciadamente van sobre agenda.
Exactamente, y aunque no lo crean, me contuve, no fui una fangirl loca, no fui, lo abracé y todo el mundo se diera cuenta de que me tenían que sacar de ahí.
Lo cual definitivamente estuvo por suceder, ¿verdad? Pero bueno, Tal vez. Ya platicamos con John Hammond, ya platicamos con Dr. Wu, ya platicamos con Dennis Nedry, con Ian Malcolm, el actor secundario.
Ajá.
Y con el de verdad, incluso tuvimos contacto y hasta de una estrechada de manos en el panel de discusión. Bueno, esta atracción de Jurassic Park The Ride me parece que está fue abierta por ahí del 95-96.
Del 96.
96 es correcto. Y está cumpliendo ya pues también muchos años, por lo cual va a ser cerrada. Vamos a ser privilegiados de podernos subir por una quizás última vez antes de que cierren la atracción, que piensa reabrirse en el 2019.
Exactamente, y también ya nos dijeron que tenemos pases para cuando la estrenen, para poder venir y hacer una cobertura completa de cómo está el nuevo juego.
Y yo creo que nosotros como fans mexicanos merecemos calidad y material especial, y yo creo que vamos a hacer todo lo posible por estar aquí en un futuro, esperemos, bueno, ya definido, que es en el 2019. Amigos, esto es un placer estarles transmitiendo en vivo.
En vivo, y ahorita lo que vamos a hacer, nos vamos a subir al juego. No se los podemos transmitir en vivo porque se va a mojar el celular, pero lo que sí voy a hacer es que voy a grabar todo con mi cámara a prueba de agua, y pues básicamente van a ser nuestros últimos momentos aquí en Universal Studios Hollywood Jurassic Park, el 25 aniversario.
Amigos, pues se acerca la aventura del River Adventure. Saludos.
Para que todos ustedes lo puedan ver. Nos tocó el bote nosotros solitos.
El número 14.
El número 14, nosotros tres. También viene mi marido.
Todavía. Alex. El mencionado.
Que se vea atrás, mira. Tenemos
el panel de control.
Las cámaras, todo. Esta es la última vez, la última experiencia que vamos a estar teniendo la oportunidad de vivir. Tantos años y se acabó. Adiós, The Ride. Bueno, pues a disfrutar.
Aquí por lo menos en Hollywood, porque el de Orlando todavía va a seguir vigente. Así que, bueno, pues espero que lo disfruten, porque ni modo de que quieran ver nuestras caras todo el juego, ¿verdad?
Está buenísimo. Está muy bueno.
Bueno, vamos a grabar lo que se pueda. Va a estar medio oscuro, digo, es Jurassic Park The Ride en la noche, in the dark. Así que, bueno, vamos a grabar lo mejor que se pueda.
Disfrútenlo, amigos.
Disfrútenlo, chicos. ¿Listo para mojarte?
Ready.
Yo ¿Listo? No estoy ready, definitivamente no estoy ready.
Yo menos, hace mucho frío, pero ¡vámonos!
A la última, amigos.
Time. The ultrasaurs in this lagoon are the largest creatures ever to live on the Earth. Despite their awesome size, these gentle giants pose no threat to us.
La cámara no le hace justicia, pero está padrísimo.
Jurassic Park scientists provide our herbivore friends with a strictly controlled organic diet, ensuring healthy growth and balance around the
ecosystem. Y el caos hizo de las suyas, amigos.
Exacto.
Y si no mal recuerdo, aquí este carro solía caer.
Una vez lo hizo, sus años gloriosos.
Pero ahora ya está ahí abajo. Y bueno, teníamos que traer algo de nuestro rancho por acá.
Bueno, chavos, espero.
espero lo hayan disfrutado. Ya nos mojamos por ustedes, más les vale que lo agradezcan.
Así, Alex, un placer compartir con ustedes esta velada. Ha sido una experiencia inolvidable, estos dos días han sido geniales y lo que les sigue, o sea...
Ahorita nos vamos a subir a la momia para secarnos.
Ah, buena idea.
The full Jurassic Park experience, ahora sí.
Exactamente, the full Jurassic Park experience. Nada más falta que compremos nuestra fotito y la subiré al grupo después. Chavos, nos vemos luego.
Amigos, estoy transmitiendo desde el Outfitters con pura celebridad. Miren quién anda por acá.
¡Yo, otra vez!
Y yo también. Say hi, Mexico.
A ver, voltea.
Going to turn them.
En caso de que no sepan, chicos, en caso de que no sepan, él es Matthew Brando, tiene su propio canal en YouTube y él es Derek Davis. Él tiene el YouTube de Jurassic Time.
Wait, it's like I make a very special video presentation as a lot of Macy's make
it. Y acá de este lado tenemos a dos miembros de Jurassic Outpost.
Outpost. Woo. Rock and roll.
Say your name for the camera.
I'm Tim Chinfano. I help with photography and such, and other media.
And?
I am Brian.
Woo! Rock and roll!
I'm not Brian.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Así que pura celebridad aquí.
Pura celebridad aquí, chicos. ¿Cómo ven? En la tienda de Jurassic Outfitters nos estamos encontrando muchísima gente. Está súper padre. Estamos estorbándole a todo el mundo.
Esto no acaba. Esto apenas va a empezar.
Exactamente.
Bueno, continuemos. De hecho, nuestro
amigo... Pero ya vamos
Matt,
a comer algo, que me muero de hambre.
Nuestro amigo Matt nos hizo una transmisión. Bueno, hizo un video y lo va a subir más adelante. Está muy interesante todo esto. Bueno.
Bueno, pues nos despedimos otra vez, vamos a comer y nos vemos al ratillo.
Un pequeño clip nada más.
Microclip de que nos encontramos todos aquí.
Continuamos por aquí.
I'm in the way.
Brian, you want to go this way?
Yeah.
Please show credential.
Eso todo cerrado.
Tienes que comer afuera.
Pues creo que ya nos dio la noche. Ya están cerrando todo. Están todavía el caricaturista. Vamos a mostrar tantito de esto que no mostramos el día de ayer. Ahí está el caricaturista haciendo toda su arte. Muy bien, no se alcanza a ver ni modos. Pero bueno, anda usando aerógrafo. Ahí estaban los cócteles, no les mostramos, pero pues ahí también teníamos cócteles. Ahorita están cerrando por áreas. Esto ya es como que lo último de lo último. Miren la luminaria que tenemos en el suelo. Y ahí arriba... tenemos pues la caída del ride, que es todo ese edificio, el que les mostré ayer en imágenes de cómo se iba construyendo. Ahí está el set, nuestra última pasada por aquí.
Nuestra última caminata por aquí.
Las puertas emblemáticas del Jurassic Park, del River Adventure, el Jurassic Outfitters, Jurassic Falls, en fin, hasta los ridículos por acá. Bueno, creo que los ridículos los hicimos nosotros estos dos días. Fueron dos días muy emocionantes, excitantes.
¡Hola!
Eso.
¿Qué tal, amigos?
¡Saludos a Mexico City!
¡Mexico City! ¿Qué tal?
¡Mexico fans!
¡Say hi, guys!
¡Say hola! ¡Say hola!
¡Hey, what's up? ¡Hola!
¡Hola!
We're live streaming to all our friends in Mexico.
¡Hi, guys! Welcome to the end of Jurassic Park, the weekend 25th anniversary celebration.
Yeah.
Yep.
We saw Jeff Goldblum on the stage.
We touched Jeff Goldblum.
We shared hands.
You touched Jeff Goldblum?
Like this.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
I touched him and I talked to him. Oh. And he recorded
them. Did you feel the alcohol on his breath?
Really? Not that close, but
okay.
We knew that he was kind of cold.
Oh, wow.
It was chilly though.
Yeah, it's kind of cold now, so.
It has been very cold this.
This is not LA weather.
No.
Yesterday was really cloudy, and the day before also. So
cold, it rained yesterday. And I was over here, City Walk.
Yeah, it was raining.
I was with Victoria.
I was wearing my full Ellie costume, like short shorts.
Oh, jeez.
My God, I was freezing to death. My hands turned blue.
Oh, wow. That's cold.
Yeah, no, I was so cold, and it was a little, like, little rain.
It was drizzling. It was drizzling about maybe 11 or something.
Yeah, yeah. I had to buy this hoodie in order to not freeze.
That's a nice hoodie. It's sideways. Oh.
It says, do not turn the...
Oh, no. There we go. Hey, what's up?
Mija, acómate.
¿Qué pasa?
Hola. Adios.
Adios.
Hola. Adios.
Goodbye. That's it. End stream.
I've been doing that all day.
Okay. One last goodbye.
Papá, ¿quieres ir a mascotear a tu amigo el Espino?
Well, I quiero mascotear al Espino. I made a video with that Spino.
Yeah.
Before I go, I made like... There, and I returned. That video has more than 4,000
reproductions. Yeah,
it was viral.
You know what's funny? I took a video of the Spino and I did this.
Really?
Yeah. I'm a T-Rex guy.
How did you make the Spino?
How did what?
How did you show the Spino?
I said the Spino's over there.
You want to recreate scene?
You want to?
Yeah, let's go. It's Jurassic.
You can leave it by.
He wants to recreate the middle finger.
Oh, okay. All right.
He's live streaming.
That was funny. That was funny.
Yeah. Actually, there's kids over there, so I don't know.
You can tell us step by step what you did to make that video and.
Oh, you're talking about Mattel stuff? Oh, you're talking about this?
About the finger.
Okay, so what I did was I like T-Rex, right? I don't like Spinosaurus. Jurassic Park 3 was of a film. So what I did was this. There's no kids, right? Here, shoot the Spinosaurus. I'm gonna get it. This is what I did. I did that.
Okay.
I did that.
Well, that's my favorite dinosaur.
Oh,
it doesn't matter.
Man.
It doesn't matter. I wanted to have a special moment with you guys.
Okay. So, ballet.
Nice. Sí, se llama prognata. Es prognata,
yeah,
¿no?
Yeah, I can see.
Yeah, no.
Just like the chomping rice.
Look from here.
It's bad.
Really
yeah, it's supposed to be really bad.
Están criticando a mi amigo el Espino, pero no importa.
Mira, tu amigo el Espino me la pela, así que me vale.
Bueno, voy a censurar esa parte en el video más adelante, pero ni modo.
Ay, papá, ya si le dieron el dedo al pobre Espino, ya.
Pero es chistoso, pero ya decir que te la...
I used to know so much Espanol, but I lost it all in college. Lost it all after college. I just know, let's say.
Levántate.
Get up.
Muy bien. Take care.
Bye, Matthew.
Eres el amigo Matthew, el que hace los reviews de los juguetitos.
Zona donde está el Raptor Encounter, generalmente aquí se pone un Velociraptor de tamaño muy inmenso.
En esta ocasión nos vamos a poner nosotros.
Así que yo voy a recrear como si fuera el Velociraptor y me voy a poner...
¡Ay, Dios! Me dejaste sordo. Oye, ¿quieres recrear esa escena donde te agarras de los cables y le haces... ¡Ah!
¡Oye, sí!
Esto va a estar interesante. Esto es épico, amigos. Bueno. Yo también quiero hacerla. A ver, ahora me haciendo también
a
eso.
A ver. Te grabo.
¡Ah! Tenía que hacerlo.
Temprano tenía que hacerlo.
¿Quiénes son los más locos de todo el evento? Los mexicanos, a huevo.
Eso. Bueno, pues ya, esto es ya la despedida de la despedida. Dicen que el que mucho se despide,
es que no quiere ir.
Todavía
no.
Tiene batería en el celular.
No nos queremos ir, la verdad, nos queremos quedar aquí como exhibición.
Ya está levantando el escenario.
Pero fue divertido mientras duró,
la verdad.
Y pues...
Duró 3 días.
Qué diversión.
Y pues, ni modo, chicos, nos tenemos que ir ahora sí.
Mándale saludos a Betito, dice...
¡Hola, Beto!
Hola, Betito.
¿Has comprado tu llavero, Beto?
Ya, ya.
Ya traemos aquí tu llavero, hijo.
Ya traemos todo tu itacate, ya, ya. Ya se lo di a Roberto.
Sí, ya.
¿Eh, hijo? Pues ahora sí, un último bye bye. Uh-huh. Del último, del último. Ok.
Viendo a para atrás.
Ay, no alcanzo a ver.
Dice, tira el teléfono.
Oh, no.
Dice, no. Adiós.
Rara. No te caigas, no te caigas, no te caigas. Mira, ahí está. Con el ride allá
así
atrás.
No te cuernos. Peace out.
Bye, chavos.
Bye.